Mines. It is, what day is it? I'm even forgetting what day it is.
It's the 7th, 20th.
Wednesday. It's Wednesday. You know, one week goes into another. It's Wednesday. So we had the 4th of July. You saw that fantastic live from Marga. She did such a great job and you really enjoyed it. I'm actually going to try something that she did as well because I want to see how that looks. And I'm going to finish my jars from last week from Friday because with the kids around, I did not get to do that much. And although I do a lot, but different things that I can't show yet. But and it's, yeah, so it's, let me see, I need to see, oh yeah, it works. We had a wall built and the wall wasn't good. So we need to take it down and yeah, so. Lots and lots of stuff going on. Never a dull moment at the Vandenberg households, I have to say. So, first of all, I need to mention two winners because Marga didn't get a winner. We forgot to give that to her. So, Anita Wong and Cindy Fraser Steventon. You both are the winners of the $50 gift certificate. And if you like, comment and share, you make a chance for another $50 gift certificate. So, Anita Wong and Cindy Fraser Steventon, congratulations. Contact info at ecraftdesigns.com. That's for all your questions and for to claim your prize. And Angel will make sure you get that. So I'm going to work with the mason jar and the florals. I'm also finished my coloring. I did that last night. Started that last night. And that is such a cool thing to do, I have to say. Really pleased with the outcome of that one. So let's turn the camera around. And then I get started. And before I forget to say as well, we have the spotlight. I'm going to use a little bit of stenciling. We have the stencils in spotlight and we extended it one day. Normally it ends on Tuesday, but we extended it one day because I did not get to use any stencils last week, but it's spotlight 50. So spotlight 50 for 50% discount on the selected stencils. And also there are some on sale, like the one from Suzanne Cannon. We have a few left of those. And those are actually, you know, they're almost free already. And now it's like almost a giveaway. So those are really cool. And I know like this one, Caitlin uses this one a lot. So check that out. And Anna will put the link in there. Oh, you finished your homework? Yeah, I know, Angelique. I'm a little bit worried about that, Angelique, because I saw the prep from some people is really, really amazing. So I feel I need to step up. I need to step up because I see so many fun things already. But that's going to be fine. So what I did is, you know, I used the Summer Art Special paper to cut these, some light blue, some craft paper. You know that I did this wrong, that I needed to do that. That's what I showed on Friday. But I want to show you the coloring first. So this one I stamped on the vellum. Using, and that's the stamp of course from Diane and Sonia, so I use the archival ink to stamp on that. I'm sorry, kindness is a set. Kindness is the stamp set, and I stamped it twice, so this way and this way. I stamped it on this side, but then when you start coloring, Cindy not showing as shared anymore. Oh, Anna, they can't share anymore.
They should have.
Yeah, I know we were, you know that shooting star. We were talking about that shooting star earlier. That was. Do you see share?
People are sharing.
Oh, people are sharing. Yeah, so it should be able. But before I forget to say, there is a shooting star now new. Next to that blue thumb, I see that. Don't touch that because you need to pay for those stars. We actually saw it the first time with Esther's live on Tuesday on her badass page. And that shooting star, if you click on that, you buy stars. And then apparently we get a little bit of money and probably most of it goes to Facebook. I don't know yet, but we don't want your money for the lives. So don't do that for us because we're fine. We're fine. I'd rather have you spending that money on things that you love to use than sending it to Facebook. But apparently that's a new thing. And if you click on that by accident, you're paying. So I stamped with archival ink. And then if you start coloring with your Copic, it picks up the ink. So you don't want to do that. So you turn it around and then I color on the back sides. And because it's transparent, you actually see the image there really well as well. So I did the green already. And then I took two blues. And what this does... Yeah, Belinda, yeah, you don't, yeah. sometimes things happen, but I hope they don't ban me from the page. Yeah. Oh, from Vienna. That is gorgeous. That is gorgeous. So what I'm going to do, of course, you need to stay in the line because otherwise it shows on the other side. But basically, you just, and with your Copic, of course, you have a nice tip. So it's super easy to color. Now, I need to be careful because I leave a little bit of light blue because I want to do a line of light blue there. But you see, and you make sure you, basically, I hardly push the pen on the paper. It touches really lightly. And you want to make complete strokes, because if you don't do complete strokes, so here I go along the line a bit, and then I do that, and here I will leave a little bit of light blue for there. But it's super fun to do, and it colors really nicely, I have to say. So I really liked the effect of this one. And then I have a light blue. Yeah, the share, I don't know how everything works. Sometimes. I'm sorry?
I said if there's an issue, I'll count the comments.
Oh, if there's an issue for sharing, Anna counts the comments as well. So that's nice. Thank you. So then this one, you see, so I will do some of the large one, and then I will go to the florals first. But you see, I kind of go along the line first, so I don't go out of the line. And it blends, like it mixes, because it makes lines. So it's kind of... Well, you know what I mean, probably, because it makes lines. So you want to make sure you make complete strokes. Don't stop in the middle, because if you stop in the middle, it's not going to look nice. But if you do that, you can always go back, because I can go over this again. So if I stopped somewhere in the middle, I don't like it, you can actually go back and then do the full strokes again. It probably would make more sense to end there, but for my feeling, it's... You see, and then here I did the like this one, for instance, I did the kind of went around the corner here, around that center of the floral. But it's super, super nice to do that. And then I take my light again. Yeah, Amy, this is it's very, very nice to do. And you can make the most beautiful cards or pages. And I saw some gorgeous mason jars already. Wow, you are making such a nice ones. There was one this morning, I don't know the name anymore, but she made one with a summer special from Ilse and Charlene, and one with the collection from Josette, yeah, with the crab. And that looked so nice. And some of the things that we were missing in the Netherlands, I know some of that was shipped and arrived. I don't know exactly which ones, but the seaweed, I think we were missing. And I think that arrived again. You see, so just strokes, and I need to look at the comments because in my eyesight, I see, you see, and it's just, yeah. And I always say you never get bored with coloring. So with this, it's what you need to do is make sure you have the kind of the full strokes. So you see, line them up next to each other. I don't go back and forward because I think that's not, then it's not going to be as nice. And what I did with the center, let me show you. I just took a little bit of the yellow. Hi, Anya. Okay, Kathleen. Yeah, I see. Yeah, the blue flower is good. Yeah, the stems are really nice, Brooke. The stems. Hi, Joseph. The stems from Sonia and Diane are really, really nice. Oh, great. I'm waiting. Tracy, it didn't arrive today. We need the summer drink. Angelique. The summer drink, I think, is sold out, but I'm working on something. So be patient. Be patient. I'm working on something. So now I turn this around, and what you see what I did here, I took my white gel pen, so I colored that center, and then I can work with my white gel pen. So you kind of have some, you see, so some dots here, which is on the other side then. So then I protect my, I'm not afraid that I go back in there with my Copic marker. You see, so now you have your dots there. And I could highlight these dots a little bit, but I, in this case, I like to leave them black, because that's, of course, that's in the stamp. So I love that. So yeah, for the people in Europe or the Netherlands that are waiting for that summer drink, yeah. I cannot say anything yet, but we're working on something. So Just be patient. Yeah? Yeah. Thought you meant an actual summer drink at first. That's Esther.
Oh, that was me.
Oh, well, this was you. Oh. I know. The summer. It's actually still dry here. We had a lot of days that we had sun and then the rain came. So, yeah. Yeah. So you see, so this is going to be a really nice page. You can imagine if you take this off, this will be a really nice card as well. You see, like that. You can do a stand-up card, like if you do another one in the back here, and then it can stand up like that. So I think just stamping and working on the vellum, I do not do that enough. Color numbers on your flowers. Oh, from your Copic. So what the ones I used, good question, is the Y18 Lightning Yellow. Then I have the BG45. It says Nile Blue. Then I have the BG07 Petroleum Blue. And then the YG17 for the green. So those are the colors I used. If you didn't get it, Y18, BG45, YG17, and BG07. Yeah, 07. Okay, so I'm going to put this aside for a second. And then I'm going to make some florals. I did make some small ones already at home. I also cut, you know, this one. Because I think somebody mentioned it. We were talking about books, like recipe books. And I think this one is, of course, super cool to put in a jar. Let me finish that one first. So this is a page from the Planner Essentials. You see, and oh, you dodged the hurricane, Ellen. Yeah. Has it been bad there or not? Yeah. Yeah. So you see, so I used only the whisk there. And what you do, if you want to do that, you just cut this. So there's actually, when you die cut this, this one makes an embossed line. So you kind of follow that embossed line. And I'm going to double this up so, because I want to have that one silver. And then I hope I can line it up really nicely. Because then it's a little bit more sturdy. So you go this way. And then if you want to have the whole whisk, you go this way as well, of course. So then you trim this. And I thought that will be a cool thing to use in the jar. I should edge this a little bit. This is a very clean and... a clean looking whisk. And then I do this one. This one has tape on the back. Oh yeah, exactly, Belinda. That's really cool. But oh, you got rain, Ellen. Okay, today's beautiful. So it wasn't that bad. Yeah, well, I have seen rain in Florida. It was horrible, but yeah, we got quite a bit of rain as well. But okay, so I got that. So I cut this out of the Tim Holtz metallic paper. And then I'm going to get this towards me a little bit more so I can kind of see what I'm doing. Because, of course, I want to line this up perfectly. So I'm just laying this down. And if you see a little bit of blue, that's actually not that bad. But, I should have put my release sheet behind it to see. But you can kind of line it up very nicely. And then my whisk is a little bit stronger. This, and now I'm going to trim it off actually a little bit higher because my idea, what I wanted to do, kind of to make it more, I'm going to etch it first. But you see, this will be super cool to use with that one. I want to etch it a little bit first with probably my vintage photo here, or no, the spruce or something. I don't want it to be too, yeah. Yeah, Lisanne, well, you have a lot of ideas as well. But it's with all the products we have, it's just easy to come up with fun stuff. I noticed the florals three burner. Yes. Oh, the florals three burner has a price of zero at the moment. Something went wrong there. So you're not getting it for free. We will call you. There must be a... Anna, can you check that? Yeah. That is not correct. Thank you for that. It must be a glitch somewhere because it's on the US side, it's correct. Yeah. Mark is actually building a wall at the moment, so. But we will contact the people that actually thought they get it for free. Can't do that. Then I would not be standing here anymore. But thank you for noticing that. There we go. And then I want to do a little bit of twine around there. Yeah, thank you, Tracy, for that. We just put it on, so it must be something that must have not picked up well or something. I never know how that stuff works. Okay, you see, I want to do a little bit of twine around it with, so I'm going to do a little bit of glue so it looks more country. So I'm going to do some glue here around the back. And then I'm just going to put this around here like two times or something. That's, there we go. I'm going to trim this. Here we go. Are there any stocks of the strawberry dyes on the EU websites? Oh, I need to look. There is another transfer order going. Anna, can you make a note if I check the strawberries for the EU website? Because if it's not there, it might be that it's on order. Because if it was sold out, we probably would have sent. Is it sold out? Do we have plenty in the US? Or maybe you've ordered it. Could also be that it's an order. So then we just need to wait. Oh, I know for sure we ordered it because I actually went through the list with you. So I know for sure it's on order. So that's going to be a little 3 weeks, I think, then before it's back in stock. Like that. And then I think it might be nice if we just add like a little thing there. Like a little, maybe I do a little bit thicker twine. I have that as well. You see, and then you have a fun whisk to put in your jar. I misplaced an entire tin of mini distress inks. I always say that's a woman thing, I think. We lose stuff. And then we find it like right in front of us. That's the worst thing. That you find it right in front of you. Okay, so this one. This one. Oh, did he fix it?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. This is actually cool. Fun. This would be a fun, like if you give somebody, I know, like a cook or baking magazine or a book or whatever, and you use this as a hanging thing, like as a card. Oh, it's a little bit thick for the, No. Little correction, it's too thick for the, unless I do it differently, but then it's not going to stick maybe. Now I'm going to do a little bit thinner. This is too thick. I need to stick with this one. I know I have another one at home, but like on Friday, I did so much I didn't get to the flowers. I mean, need to make sure that I don't have the same this time. I've checked home, the store, the car. So yeah. Did you do a class or something? Did you go somewhere with your stuff? Then it might be there, but yeah. In a shadow box, yeah, that's also fun. Like with a nice picture, if you put a nice picture with it. You see, I think that's cool. So, and now if you can see if you want to make like a baking one, you can see if you do a clear window and you see it behind the window, of course, can stick out a little bit, that's fun. I think that's a cool idea as well. Yeah. Ik een pootje stans van de haan kwijt, oh, from the rooster. Lost the rooster legs. Oh, yeah, it's that. You know what happens sometimes as well? If you work with magnetic sheets, then it flips to another sheet. Don't you have that? That you can find it there? Yeah. Okay, so that was an idea that I thought this morning. Oh, I need to show that. Then, you know what would have been nice actually on this one? Because I wanted to do some stenciling. Oh, that might be nice. I'm going to try that. Wait, but then with, not with paste. Just with... do I have an ink that kind of matches? This will be nice when it's a line. Ba-ba-ba-ba. But color, color, color. Eye spruce. Let me see how that looks on. Which one did I just use for the edging? I need to use that one. It's, you see, that one must be right... Oh, here. I want to say that one must be right in front of me because I just used it. I'm going to use that. But then I'm not going to do it all the way up. But of course, I should have done that with before I do all the twine. But I think that will still be cool to see. I think that will be fun. Oh yeah, I like that. Just a little decoration on the whisk makes it a little bit more fancy. There you go. So that is the whisk. I use my kitchen dies all the time. Great invention. Yeah, did you see? A lot of people make cookbooks with it because, of course, and this one is a great one for recipes because if you take like the solids and then you take the cutout pieces from the window, and you can also, because that's a die and, as itself, so you take these ones and you put them on here, then you can make a little label with a recipe here, put a lid on that, and how cool is that? I think that will be really nice. I called my mother for the, I don't know how many times this week, for deviled eggs. Deviled eggs is gevulde eieren for the Dutch people, and because my moms are the best, of course. And I finally wrote it down because I'm just anything that has to do with cooking, I'm not the best. But doing that, and then you can just do lines, put lines on it, or you cut a recipe out of a book and you can stick it on there. If you, but that's just, yeah, that will be nice. Okay, so that one, and then now I'm going to work on my florals that are going on this one. But you can see already, and this one I kind of want to make into a book with like a summer, spring, just like a fun, happy colors little book. So that's going to be this one. Maybe it's time that I ask my mother for more recipes, because honestly, I am a really bad at that. But I love the whisk. That is just super fun. Super fun. Okay, so I was going to work with this one. So that's the floral I'm using, floral 13. And I did grab a few samples that were made with the same. You've seen them already. But you see, that's the tag that Anita created. Then that's the card. It's actually the florals from the packaging. And then these ones are the same. You see, so you see all the diversity you can do. And that's another card. And I know Anita posted this already, but look at that. Just gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So that's all done with the same set. And I'm going to make mine in turquoise. So I have them here. And this is the, so you get the three leaves, the center, and the florals. And I'm going to combine it with some other florals as well. I did make the small ones already. You saw me doing that. That's actually from the earlier release. So I die cut two small flowers, etch it with yellow, added the stamen. And that's going to be a filler that I'm going to use on there. But I thought I'm going to do the leaves. I'm going to do in the technique that Marja did because I want to see how that works. So I cut all my leaves here. And I know she just used like a distress, I think. And then, or another ink. And then spritz it a bit and dipped it in there. I think she used oxides, by the way, if I'm correct. If I'm correct. But you should check it out. That's the live from Monday, because that was honestly really nice. What I wanted to show you as well, what I might, I don't know if I did that already, but in Creative Scrapbooker from the summer issue, summer 2021, I made something with the florals. I made this one. That's a storage tin. It has four compartments. I found it in one of the craft stores here. I did the florals and I just used a hot glue gun to add them to the tin. I have this one in Canada. It's actually super cool. It's in my studio there. So that's just an idea for something, because Marja did a cutting board that you can hang. But I thought like the just the storage thing is very very fun as well. Okay, I have here. Let's do. I'm going to do two colors. This is always this one, like the crushed olive, that's always a little bit of a kind of, I never know if I like it or not. But I'm just going to do two colors, and I'm just going to see if I can kind of, yeah, thank you. That thing is actually really nice. I see Anita, there is actually some flowers from Anita on there as well, that I just picked from a card. Did, I think she did the other, it actually looks nice. Huh. And then, oh, now the color is gone. And then if I etch it a little bit, it actually looks super cool. Why did I never do that before? You see, that's why we learn. We need to see from other people. And I can just leave this to dry. And then I etch it a little bit. And then super fast way to make some nice, yeah, the crafty bin. Yeah, I got it. At one of the big stores here, because I had to find something that was they asked me something to do, not a card. I actually made something for the next issue, which is really cool. It's also something decorative. I have it here, but I'm not allowed to show you, of course, because it's going to be in a magazine. But it's right here next to me. But it's also with the new florals. And I know I can go back and just, I like the diversity of it. This is easy. Easy peasy. Thank you, Marga. I don't know if you're here. But I thought I'm going to do a combination. So I'm going to color my, I like the one with the splatters better. And then I know I can go back to get that. This one, see some dots, and it's better to do it when it's dry, of course, but you can go back and kind of get some, you pick it up then in the more drier part of the ink. See, I can pick up some dots there. That's quick. I know, I think Marga did them all this way, but I think it's also a nice combination because I started them with coloring with the ink, but with the dauber. So I thought the combination of the two might be nice. So I just wanted to try that. I'm going to use the back of the ink to kind of, and then these can dry, kind of to.
Marga said she did distress ink now.
Oh, she used distress inks? Oh, okay, thank you. Yeah. And I think with oxides, you can, of course, get the same effect. You see, I just give the back a little bit of color using up what's here. But, cool idea. Never done that. And then I probably will etch it a little bit. I'm just picking up everything that's left. There we go. So that can dry. And then I'm going to color my flowers. And she did a great, I have to say, Marga did a great composition. But honestly, with the flowers, I've seen beautiful things already. But especially on the, like with the mason jar. Ooh, I know. Jennifer, that's really quick, this. That's why it's a nice technique, because if you want to do something a little bit faster, I'm going to do two more small flowers. I'm just going to color, I'm going to do two of these, and two of these. Let's do this. Okay. Let's see if I can do that quick as well. Oh, which one? I think I did broken china and tumbled glass or something. I don't know exactly, but I think I did. Oh yeah, I'm going to make a recipe book with family recipes and pics of each person. Susan, that is such a great idea. That's honestly, that is, when I see that, I know, who did that? Did Ruli do that? The recipe books with her daughter? No, I don't think so. Well, it's a cool idea to do that. And although I don't cook, I know we have a lot of family recipes. My grandfather was actually a pastry chef, so he made the nicest cakes, and I need to store that. I know my sister, he made the best creme, how do you call that? The creme au beurre, you call this here different. It's not icing, because icing here is just sugar, but creme au beurre is like if you do that well, it's really nice. Just a little bit of color on the back. I'm just going to do this color first. Yeah, the leaves are lovely with coloring. Yeah, Nancy. That's, of course, so all credit to Marga for me, because I know probably 1,000 people did this already. I don't know. But I didn't use it for the flowers yet. And I thought, oh, I'm going to try. And this is, so this is the combination of the crushed olive and the peeled paint. And it's nice to, yeah, it comes out nice. It's a kind of a nice fresh color. I'm going to add it a little bit. I'm just dabbing a little bit. And then I'm going to the second color. Crème brûlée. No, crème brûlée, so is crème au beurre. Crème brûlée is something totally different. Crème brûlée, I love that, by the way. But crème brûlée, so crème au beurre is with a lot of butter. That's beurre. Butter is beurre. And it has nothing to do with crème brûlée. But I do love crème brûlée. It's kind of a... yeah, it's, you know, I think we would use it as icing here, but it's not icing. Icing is really sugary, and crème au beurre, I think, is probably more butter. Buttercream. Oh, do you call that buttercream? And you can make it like in a taste, in mocha or strawberry or vanilla. And I know it's hard to make in the sense that it can... Schifter, what is this? I have no idea what that is. So when you don't do it correct, it schifts. But I don't know the word for that. Angelique, what is schiften in English? So then it gets like, it needs to be nice and smooth. It needs to be nice and smooth. And when you do it wrong, it's, I don't know the word for that. But it's, a buttercream. Okay, yeah. Oh, warm, humid New Hampshire. It's actually warm here as well. It's warm in the studio. It's, but I don't know. I don't see any clouds outside now, because we might get some clouds and, well. Oh, and Annette, I saw Annette here. So Annette is, so next week you're in for a treat. I will do the live on Friday. On Monday it will be Lisanne. Oh, you're Googling, Angelique. Thank you. Schiften. So it's schiften van de crème. Yeah, and so Monday Lisanne will be here, and on Wednesday Annette will be here as well. So that's going to be a treat, two treats. Yeah, double the amount of icing sugar to put. I have no idea what we're talking. You know, anything I have to say, anything that has to do with cooking. Yeah. Yeah, Annette has a great video on with. Schiften is curdle of split. Curdle of split. Anna, do you know what it is?
What?
Schiften in Dutch is curdle of split. Do you know what curdle of split is?
No.
No, yeah, also no cook. No cook. yeah, Annette has a really nice video, like a YouTube, if you go to Annette's Green YouTube channel. And by the way, Marga Downe has a YouTube channel as well. You should visit that one as well. And then subscribe to that, because the tutorials there are fantastic. Of course, Marga, she has some in Dutch and she has some in English. Yeah. Google says curdle. Okay. People in the US, do we know what we're talking about that schiften? I should look it up as well, but I'm pretty sure you did it all correct. So again, like, comment and share for a chance to win a $50 gift certificate. And the winners were from the last two were Anita Wong and Cindy Fraser Steventon. And I have blue fingers, so now I should clean my fingers. Okay, I think I have enough flowers here to work with. Combined with the ones that I did already. Then I'm going to make those. Oh, diabetic. Yeah. Yeah, that's not fun. I should stay away from it all as well, but you know. Actually, I always say in the US, because the things I really like, I should, if I don't order from the Dutch store here, or don't visit the Dutch store, I'm pretty good. But we ordered from a Dutch wholesale, like a Dutch store. Well, yeah, there's a Dutch store here in the US, and you can order. And then, oh, that went so fast. Yeah. That was bad. So I cannot do that anymore because there is no control in licorice in my system. I forgot some to do the black on the, or the blue on the back. But, and of course, I'm using my my bone folder here again. I just love how that grip. This is a Teflon bone folder. You could do more lines if you want to. And then curl it. And I did not... Oh, when sauce making fails, what is that called? Yeah, because you can make other sauces. And then, yeah, that's it. When the oil kind of, sometimes the oil starts showing up at the top, that's kind of what it is.
I
yeah? Yeah? Just found out at about Elizabeth Christ. Oh, nice to be here. Joyce, welcome. Joy, welcome. Welcome. So if you like, comment and share this video, Joy, you, first of all, you inform your friends about us, which is great. And you make a chance to win a $50 gift certificate. Because we do that, we have a live each Monday, Wednesday and Friday. They all go to YouTube as well. So if you go to the Elizabeth Craft Designs YouTube channel, you will also find all the older ones are on there. And then we have, yeah, I see Anna putting the link. And we have basically three Facebook pages. We have the one, and actually Ilse and Charlene just started one as well with all their journal stuff. I need to find, I will mention that next time. And so we have the ECD planners and journaling. You can post all your work there. We also have the Elizabeth Craft Designs family. You can post your work there. And then, of course, we have our own Elizabeth Craft Designs. And that's where all the messages about what we do. And so that's all posted there as well. And, of course, all the Facebook Lives are there. Because if you go to videos at the top from your Facebook page, from the Elizabeth Craft Designs Facebook page, that's where you can find all the different videos. So I'm just punching this. Oh, this one I did already. I should kind of see what which different sizes I have. I think I can kind of keep them apart. And then I'm sure I have enough to make some fun florals with it. Oops. And you can combine my wallet's becoming best friends with Elizabeth Craft. Thank you, Joy. You know, we always say it's not a bad addiction to have, eh? It's not a bad addiction to have. And I honestly have to say, we have such a great group of designers and design team members and staff. So we just, you know, it's just fun. It's all fun. Unless shipping. Shipping is not fun. Shipping is a hassle still. I know people in the UK, if you're watching and you still didn't get your mason jar, don't blame Hochanda. Blame shipping. It's not fun. Oh, I wanted to edge this a little bit. Now I can do it later as well. No, let's do that first. I want to edge a little bit with the peel paint, I think. Oh, Jeanette, no cancer in my hand and cast comes off on Wednesday. Okay, Jeanette, yes. I know you had your surgery. Okay, I know, this is a good idea. Oh, that's actually, that makes it nice. Just a little bit like this. Oh, I like that. I think that just makes it a little bit more, yeah. That's actually really cool. Oh, you got your mason jar yesterday, Jen? Yeah, on Saturday I have a class with Crafters Home. With a lot of people signed up already, and a lot of people did their prep work already, and that's going to be nice. But again, I saw people prepping so organized that I need to do that as well. I need to be as organized as you all are, which I'm sure I will be. Yeah, the mason jar is super cool. And of course, the mason jar is for all seasons because you can use it for the summer, what we're doing now. You can use it as a recipe book, but look on the, if you're new here, look on our family and planner page as well, because there's a lot of mason jars showing up already. You can make it as a snow globe. You can, I'm pretty sure people will use it for the December day by day, because of course we're going to do that as well. And there will be people using it for that, because that's actually a really cool one, like to use it for winter and for the month of December. I'm just doing the back and then I can curve it kind of in the middle. And of course we have the embossed lines in the leaves. For the leaves or the flowers? Oh, the leaves. So for the leaves, I used peeled paint and crushed olive. Peeled paint and crushed olive. For the flowers, I used tumbled glass and broken china. Tumbled glass and broken china. And for the flowers that I colored earlier, I used Y18, YG17, BG07 and BG45. Oh, you also go to the Macy Dot. Oh, that is going to, I can't wait on it. And I can't wait, Lizanna, as you know, it's going to be really nice. And then because your Zets need some time, so then we have because our design team is so nice to help me with the lives. I'm going to babysit for a few days with Joop, probably, because Josette wants to finish a new collection. Josette wants to finish a new collection. So, and because this leaf has a, you can kind of fold it a little bit, you see, so that it shapes like this. And of course you can do more professional shaping if you want to. But this looks pretty. This actually, I'm so glad I saw the video from, how can I never have tried this? I love it. Love it. It's actually a really cool look, I have to say. I stopped shipping to you. Oh, yeah. Is that the UK? Yeah. Honestly, and that is why we I told it before, we had a ship, if it's going about the UK, we had a shipper picked up our pallets to the UK when Brexit happened. They just said we're stopping right away. They stopped shipping. So it's really a hassle at the moment. And I'm convinced it will work itself out during time. But right now it's still, we just can't get it there, or they don't pick up, or it's, yeah, or it sits at customs because, yeah. Okay, so that's that one. That is actually really nice. Can you imagine if you do this in like fall colors with the leaves? The maple leaf in a fall color? That will be so pretty. Do I have a cut maple leaf? I do. Let's do one. Make sure, oh, I have my, here. Wait, this technique. And then with the maple leaves, wait, let me see. Do I have some colors? I don't really have some fire brick, but I don't have, let's see how it looks. Of course, at home I have way more colors of the brown. So this is a limited, I feel that I need to have some, but I only have carved pumpkin here. That is too orangey. Let's do this. And then I have more, I see, you see, I think that's too red, but you get the idea that will be. See, that will be pretty. It's a little bit too red, so I need to go back. But you can imagine that will be really, I have too much of a line there. There you go. But you can kind of do red edges. That will be nice. So I'm definitely going to do that technique with different, like make a fall card. It will be really pretty. Now I should focus on my mason jar. Cannot leave without not finishing it again, but that's how my brain works. Oh, let's try this. That's how you can kind of see how my craft room gets messy, like this. But you can, if I edge that a little bit, that will be really pretty. Yeah, love that. That's going to be a project as well. Okay, so let's put these together. I had some larger. I thought I'm going to use this one in here. And I can also add these because that's the original. And this is really a fun one. I call it the different colors. But if I put this one in here, you see there's no hole in it, but I can easily poke through. And then I wanted to put this in the center. So that's kind of the idea. Or maybe I need to, should I make that a little bit yellow as well? Now I'm going to see. So if that's not poked through, then I take my tweezer and I poke. That's, oh, this is a tweezer with glue again. But and then kind of wiggle it a little bit so I have enough room to put a center through. Okay, so one. And of course you can do them all the same size as well and just offset them. So that's also something to do. One, two, three. Okay. So I don't use the largest one in this case. And I don't know who gave me that tip, but I finally, the amount of times I took my kids' choice group, put it upside down in water is a lot. And one of you gave me the tip to put some Vaseline or something in the lid. I actually used Anna's hand cream. But and now it doesn't clog anymore. That's such a good tip. So I should have done that like ages ago. Yeah, it's a hassle, eh, guys. It's a hassle. Shipping is a hassle. Because I know Tracy is waiting for a nice package from Ilse and Charlene. I think that's the one, Tracy, that we're talking about. And everybody has it, but not one. Yeah, for the glue. Yeah, the glue, honestly. And I should have done that 1,000 years ago, but I did not. But now I do. And it's, I want to make this a little bit bigger. Tracy has had that ship still not docked. Oh, okay, yeah. We have the, I know we have the new planners coming in by a boat. And that's, you know, it's all taking longer. So it's just, you know, it's just not easy. It is not easy. And I'm poking this one through. See, as a extra scent. You see how cool that is? And it's one of those designs, again, when Anita sent that in, that I honestly need to think, okay, is that going to be nice? And then when you use it, yeah, it is nice. It is nice. And then I always add a little bit of glue on the back here. I leave that to dry. But look, isn't that summery? I love how summery that is. I love how summery that is. Okay, leave that to dry. Then I make another one like this. Then I make some smaller ones maybe. Oh, and I color this one with, so that is a stamen. And I color this one with like Copic. Depending on what, sometimes I dip it in paint. Sometimes I use my Distress ink. But this one I know I used Copic marker on it. Ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. Just pinch and then use my tweezer, and of course I can use a little punch holder as well, but this always works. And then I kind of slide it up a little bit so I make it a little bit bigger. Thank you, Andrea. Thank you. Oh, Marga is here. Marga, did you see my leaf? Were you here all the time, Marga? Did you see what I did with your technique from the leaves? I did not see you show up earlier, so I don't know. Sorry, I don't know if you were here already, but I use your technique from yesterday. And then I should start building up on, oh, you know, I forget it. Well, you know, I will find something. I know why I wanted to color the back of the flowers as well, because I was going to put it on a vellum page. And then you see the white on the back. But I will come up with something. I can probably put some fern leaves over there or something. Don't need to do it all at the same time. And then this one. And then this one through there. There we go. And if we do that, fluff it up a bit. And then the other ones I'm going to do smaller. A little bit of glue on the back. Oh, you saw it, Marga? Yeah. Great tip. Great tip. Oh, you're also working on a recipe book? Yeah. Yeah, the mason jar, of course, is a fantastic, like the planners by itself, of course. And you can put that mason jar in your planner, eh? So, if you want to do that, there's a little bit of glue there. So that can dry. Getting a nice bouquet already. You know, with the florals, of course, you can also make, like corsages, of course. See, so that's there. Then I have all this already. You see, so these ones, I have fine stamen. I just edge the flower a little bit. And then you trim this off. There you go. Oh. And then this one. There you go. And then I am going to start. Do I want to have some small ones with just this in there? Oh, I like that. I only have two small. Oh, I can color another small one. Let me see. I kind of like, because I like that, just that small flower. And I'm just going to add a little bit of what I should do, a little bit of glue on a page. And just add some, a tiny little bit in this. I should have a stick, a wooden pick. I know I have that, but I don't know where. And then pull this through. Just as a single flower, I like that in the mix. So that needs to dry. I hope it dries. And now I do another one like that. But now I have two and two, and two and two is not working, of course. Two and two will not work. What techniques make them shiny? You mean the leaves? Vaseline. I did that as well. If you want to have shiny leaves, you use Vaseline. And you rub that on the, you rub that on your paper. I don't know if that was the question, but I know how that works, is like that. Okay. There we go. Now I need to color one more little blue one. Let me do that first, because then I have two big ones and three small ones, because if I have only two and two, that's not going to look nice. Of course, I have all those. I probably have all green now on my finger. But that first, and now the other one. Yeah, if you take a little bit of Vaseline on your fingers and you rub over the leaves, that's how they get shiny. I have it at home. I will, if I think about it, I will do that later. Okay, what am I? Oh, going over time. That's okay. Shape this one. Glossy, excellent. Oh, yeah, as well. Yes, that's correct. Glossy, like our clear craft drops. And then with a brush. Exactly. I did that. You see, I forget things. But that's correct. If you take the craft drops, I have them here. I don't know if you still have, like the clear one, so this one. And you just put a little bit on your leaf and you brush it off with a flat brush with some water. It gets really shiny as well. Yeah, the transparent crystal. I don't think we have that. We have it anymore? Don't have it anymore?
No, I don't see.
No, could be. Oh, it might be that that's gone. But I know other brands have the same transparent one. Yeah. It's in the, we still have it in the EU, but not in the US anymore. So, but then I, you know, other brands that have that as well. That one. Okay, it's going to come together and then I can start building, which is fun, of course. I love that whole bouquet stuff that's laying around now here. Oh, wait. Oops, and now my finger is clean, you see, well, from glue. It's under the table. Okay, when you try, yeah, okay, then, yeah, we don't get that back in stock. That was a one-time thing, but we still have, but then you know that there's other brands that have clear glossy stuff. And then you can use that. Okay, so I'm not going to use these for now. Put it aside. Four Bayadol left. Okay, and it's in there. Yeah, there's clear ones in there. Okay, so that's the page. And then I'm going to start with this one. It's not all really dry. I have about 5 Tim Holtz scissors in our household. And I just noticed one in Joep's in the garage. I use that scissor for everything. I made a tic-tac-toe from wooden sticks for Annika. And then I cut the wooden sticks with my, I just dip it in. Yeah, see, I need to kind of make sure that I get something on the back, but I'll come up with that because I get glue on here as well now. But I will come up with an idea to cover the back nicely. Sneak peek, watch. Oh, she did a sneak peek in a group. I don't have the dies here, do I?
They're actually just talking about the new planner colors.
Oh, the new planner colors. Oh, Anna, can you give me those? We have all those secrets here. If you give me the one, the small one, it's right in front of you. Yellow one, no, at the bottom. The planner and the that one.
Oh yeah.
Only those two. Yeah.
Yeah. You want all of them?
No, that's fine. If I have one of each, that's good. Yeah.
Why?
Because we get sidekicks and we get planners. These are the new colors. It will be. So we first will have a planner release. And then after the planner release, because we're not going to hold up because boats are so unpredictable. So we're going to do a planner release. And then as soon as these are in, we will release those. So we get both the colors in the sidekick and the planner. So this kind of a skin, what's it called?
Crocodile?
Yeah, crocodile.
It's not real crocodile.
Yeah, kind of. No, it's of course it's fake. Mm-hmm. It's fake. But that's... And then with this color on the inside, kind of a tan. Yeah, it's beautiful. And then the other one is going to be this one, kind of with an ostrich. I think you call it an ostrich print. Love this one. Okay, I think I was silent. The sound went off for a second. Did you see the colors? You all saw it, eh? The sound went off for a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to tuck in some leaves already. Yeah, Mike. Yeah. No, I didn't burn my mic off. The batteries were off in the other one. I'm just going to cut off the statement. The batteries, we have two here, so mine were good. But Anna's were off. But we're back. Oh, I like the look of that. No sound. I know. I know I'm back when I'm talking to you. Yeah, it's back. Yeah, I know. Batteries from... I was okay. I did not bump the sound of the batteries were gone. Like that. It's such a waste because then we say, oh, we have two bars left or something. And then you need to change your batteries because the risk that it turns off, but then they're not like done yet. So I kind of feel bad. Oh, let's
go.
I'm sorry?
We're saving them.
Yeah, we're saving them. Yeah, that's correct. We're saving them. Yeah. I'm just taking those little stamen off to kind of tuck them under. Kind of in between the leaves here. And then I also want to of course include a beautiful that one. I don't know if I want to have it in gold or I also have the fern leaves. Choices. We have too many beautiful choices. This is the lacy one in like the... Maybe I use that. You see, I cut it up already. Do we have any more parts of that? I also have gold. Actually, gold is nice as well. Choices. Oh, I actually like the gold. Can't use the gold one. And then, of course, we have that beautiful, those beautiful fern leaves as well. I have a natural one. I have it in... No else. Okay, this should be enough to build with. Going to add some of these. Another small one maybe here. Yeah. Let's see. Hey, Nell Langbroek. Hey, I have a family member here. Leuk hier te zien, Nell. Another Nell. We have another Nell. Nelly. So Nell, we have another Nell here in the US as well. And she's actually born in Vlaardingen, but she lives in the US. Yeah. So I think that is nice. You know what I have as well? I saved the inside dots from that. And that fell out of that. So I'm going to add those. Oh, Honora. Yes, I know. You had the kids. Yeah, you need to relax a bit.
Did you make the lacy leaf with Tim Holtz wallpaper?
Yes, I did. Yeah. Yeah. So I'm going to use those there kind of as a, almost as a branch, you see. Kind of here. So those are the leftover pieces from my heart. And then I'm going to add some of the little ones. Just dip them in the glue. Kind of add them. Oh, I cannot. Oh, I can do that here. Because the simply the best goes around. Kind of put it here. Oh, I like it. I like it. I like it. Oh, your hubby's watching. Is there a soccer match at the moment? Is the UK still in? Sorry, I'm not. I'm missing the soccer. I know the Netherlands is out. I know that for sure. Wait, I want to use these as well. Let me see if I'm going to do that. And if not, that is fine because... Oh yeah, I like that. I might add a little leaf then there. And kind of chuck my... Thank you, Belinda. This is just so much because you just built, you kind of built your page. And it's just because I want to have that in there as well. That. And then maybe I should go around a little bit there. Just fold this up a bit. And then maybe one more there. Let me see. Let me see. I hope this is all dry already, otherwise I need to glue it back in. But I want to put here, maybe. Or on the lid, I could also do it on the lid. So that, yeah, that's a nice... And of course, if you want, you can go all the way around. I've seen that, people do that as well already. But now I have 2-2-2, but I like it, but it's basically against the rules, eh? 2-2-2. Going to add this one. Struggling. Oh, here. That is nice here. Okay, then I have 3 of the yellow ones. Okay, and then I'm going to tear this one in pieces. Oh, Engeland, Denemarken. Okay. Okay. I hope one of them wins. Is that the correct answer? It will be, yeah, because it's a kind of a, how do you call that? If it's going to be longer than the game, the one who scores first is the winner. Sudden death? Do you call it like that? Is that a sudden death at the end? When you don't have a winner? Yeah, this leaf is such a good one. And what do you say? We get herons stalking. Stalking your koi pond. Yeah, they're not stalking it. They want to eat your fish. You know that, eh? But don't need to tell you that. They're there to come and kill your fish. Yeah. Okay. So that's. And now I'm going to do a little one still. Wait, that one is that sticking. One more. And then I need to put some twine around the lid. Sorry. So one more minute then. One more minute then. Let's put this one here. It's okay if it sticks out a bit. Oh, no, it doesn't. So that one. And then I have light blue twine to go around it. And all the pieces, of course, that I've left, I always save for the next one. Oh, I don't like the light blue. It needs to be natural. Wait, I need to get my other one. Whoop. What's that? Oh, lace. Lace is falling. Yeah, I like that better. And what I did not do and what I should do is do a small label. Kind of use that small label, but I don't have that at hand. So I'm leaving that. But I like to kind of wrap this around it. And then and then I can hang a little label on there as well. I will finish that later, but there we go. It's a little bit too loose, but I can straighten that. That's fine. Cut this, and then I'll hang a little label on it later. Alrighty, and I will finish my coloring one later, and I will post a picture of that. So you see the one I started in the beginning with the stamp here. Well, I think I've been quite productive today. So let's turn the camera around, Anna, and we will say goodbye. So thank you all for watching. And I had fun. I hope you enjoyed it as well. And again, like, comment and share. And make sure to check out the sales Spotlight 50 for a selected stencil selection. And then on Friday I will be here again. We have a new spotlight then, of course. And Monday will Lisanne will be here, and Wednesday Annette Green will be here. So thank you all, and I see you again on Friday. Bye bye.